I don't know if you ever saw Chopper, but that's where I first found it. I mean, it's his first film, and it's just a great psychological profile of a sociopath. I saw this movie, and I called him up, and I said, listen, I'd love to do something if you come up with anything. And since then, we've become really good friends and worked on one of my favorite films personally, and he came up with this one, and it was a real pleasure to do. I think he's one of our great talents. One of Australia's great talents, but one of the film community's great talents. It's a great crime drama. I hear my friend Ben here next door. But that's on the surface, but underneath there's these parallels to and commentary on the time we've just gone through or still going through coming out of. And that's the bank bailout and the financial crisis. I quite enjoy it because you get to contribute films to the yearly narrative, and films that possibly say something about our time. You also get to support great filmmakers and actors and put those pieces together. So I find it very rewarding.
The way Andrew framed it, that it was going around the economic downturn that we were going through, the casting of it, it's just raw, it's smart, it's not just quick little cuts. People talk to each other and express their ideas and thoughts. So it's good. Yeah, well, I like New Orleans. It's a great place to make a movie. I mean, they get the tax breaks. That's why everybody's down there. It helped me out because I like to play poker. So on days I wasn't working, and in this movie, I'm overseeing a poker room. So I was doing my homework. I got to do my homework.
You know, I read a book, basically. George Higgins really liked it. Thought it would be a good movie, or at least something that's fun to think about for a couple of years, while you're making it. Well, our relationship has always been like, he's always been performed the producerial function. I mean, Brad, I think at this stage in his career, is concerned about his legacy, and he wants to make, wants to use his powers for good, and he's trying to make movies. Him and Dee Dee Gardner are trying to make movies that perhaps otherwise wouldn't get made. He's making movies with, Terry Malick, Steve McQueen, that kind of thing. As a producer, he's great. He's just like your 800-pound gorilla. And he's yours, though. He goes and sits on other people, and he gets you the money. He does a little bit of heavy lifting. And then as an actor, it's a very different relationship. You know what I mean? We just have a normal director-actor type relationship. I think, Jackie could be kind of a cipher, I think, if it was somebody else playing him. I think the thing about Brad, maybe the reason why he's a movie star, is you always get the feeling like you're just seeing the tip of the iceberg. You know what I mean? There's another 80% floating below the surface. He always retains some kind of essential mystery, which is maybe the reason why he's a star. You can't cast Brad as an everyman. You know what I mean? You can't cast him as a guy that's like going to the supermarket or something like that. He's either going to be like, a mythological figure, or at least somebody extraordinary, which seemed appropriate for this character.